Hello. Let me mute myself. Cool. I will wait for a few people to come in and then I'll start. But like I said, I'm streaming Sacrament. I'll wait for more people to come on. This video will probably be on YouTube too, because I'm recording it to my computer. So if you're watching it on YouTube, you'll just have to wait for me to introduce myself before people come on, etc. Okay, let's post this on Doomworld. This is like, my plans are always like super spur of the moment, so I don't expect like tons of people to be watching. A lot of people I know are at Gamer X, an event in San Jose, and plus it's the weekend, it's Friday night, but we'll just see. I wanted to try something different that would have as much value watching it live as when it's put on YouTube. Plus, I wanted to test using my microphone so that the audio quality is better. See, so I have Sacrament. There's Sacrament. Exited host mode. What? Twitch. Oh, I know what I did. I have to open up my own stream. No, it's already open. What am I talking about? Goodness, I'm not with it today. Okay. Yes, it says there are 5 people watching. Cool. Well, welcome those 5 people. Tell me if you see me in the chat. Hello. Yeah, I can't see who's appearing in the chat. Presumably, they might not have an account or something. But yeah, one thing that I would like to talk about is I was playing through Sacrament, which is one of my favorite sets. It's sort of a prequel to Alt, which I talk about all the time, and it's by this Russian group of Doom modders, mostly Russian, although one particular member who I'll talk about a lot this time is Ukrainian, but I think they have a really interesting sensibility, particularly this one author, but several authors really within this sphere. And that's kind of the thing that I wanted to talk about, what some of the things that I think are being engaged in here, just beyond, maybe just beyond being like a fun level or whatever. And I know for a lot of like people in the Doom modding community, that might be considered as overanalysis or something, but, If I do anything, it's certainly to overanalyze. So, but I think it's important to like understand what's going on and what makes some of this stuff different. Let's see if yes, several people. Cool. Hello, people. Yeah, this is Sacrament. One thing I really like about it is the custom music, which is MP3s, I presume. And most Doom mods, I guess because it takes up a lot of space, don't really use custom music like this. This is like continuing in the glorious tradition of pilfering, stealing graphics, this also steals music from various like anime sources and other stuff. I don't know. They don't credit their sources, so maybe on purpose, just they can get away with like taking it without permission. But I don't know. It kind of adds to the feeling of it, of this. But I'm not going to be starting at the beginning, I'm not going to be playing the whole WoD. It's only 13 maps, but some of the maps are quite long. I really want to talk about particular levels in it, and talk about some of the design in it and what I like, because, I don't know, when I was just playing through last night, I was like, is a lot of the things that I think are happening in this set really, or in these levels, like, is that actually happening, or am I just projecting onto it or something? And I went back and I'm like, no, this is, there's something special about this, so I should try and find a way to express what it is. This isn't exactly a prequel to Alt, it's just like the precursor. It came out in 2011, I think, and Alt came out in 2012. But yeah, it's a lot of the same group of people. There's some group that don't overlap, but yeah, a lot of the same sort of feeling and etc. I'm gonna take a drink just a second. Okay. Let's see how many viewers we have now. 7. That might not be up to date, but who cares? That's plenty. 14. Wow. Okay. Cool. Yeah, let's do it. This set is not very hard. I will play on Ultra Violence, even though I normally play on Hurt Me Plenty, just because it's not that hard. And I'm going to pistol start from this next map, or from this first map that I'll be talking about. So feel free to comment in the chat. Hello, Post-Snacks. Jacques Roch. Roller 1998. Adamine 634, Departed Spirit. Departed Spirit, that's a good name. And IDK really anymore. Let's go. So this is the first map. I love this, like, very, very low resolution bookshelf texture here. But I think we're going to start out by warping to map 10. And let me know if the audio levels and everything are fine. They should be, but we'll see. And also, hopefully I won't get any drop frames, but if I do, this will also be up on YouTube later, so you can watch it there if it gets too choppy here. All right. I'm gonna check. Cool. Let's go. I need to move this over so it doesn't cut off on my screen. So this is called Wood Prison. It's by Azamail, who is the author of many maps in Alt, about half the maps, and really the person who carries that set more than anything else. This is his first really... I'm assuming... Yes, I think he's a guy. His first really good, I'd say kind of a masterpiece. And I don't want to use that word lightly, but I think it applies here, and I'll let you know why. So this beginning area, it's pretty cool, pretty moody, but not anything unusual for Doom. We'll just move through it a little bit, and I'll also save just for the sake of saving. Sacrament. So this is less of a conventional playthrough and more of me talking about it. But one thing that I notice with a lot of his maps is there's a lot of like verticality here. The mood is also very good, although it's very persistent among the whole set. But there's a lot of contrast between spaces, like vertically, and there's also some kind of strange geometry in terms of like it's symmetrical, but then there are like stairs that go up at like weird angles and things like that. All right. So I guess this is the... Yeah, okay, I just need to hit the switch. Forgive me if I die. This map is not actually that hard, but in spite of the 306 monster count, because it's huge, so they're very spread out, and a lot of them are lower tier monsters. One thing I really like that I think distinguishes his maps from other authors is that the combat... there's always this like contrast between people who want to use Doom for this kind of more what is often called walking simulator thing, where you know, the combat is mostly incidental, and that set, the set more favors that kind of thing, versus, you know, conventional Doom combat, like going around fighting stuff, which is, you know, usually what is done in the Doom community and etc. His maps are, while they do tend to emphasize more exploration, there is also a pretty good understanding of like monster placement and things like that. And the monsters never really feel out of place with the environment. I always feel like the placement of them makes enough sense. Which is a really kind of hard to do thing. So that's one thing that I think makes his maps particularly unique. I'd say the other thing is they're very sort of playful. They do have that sort of sensibility that a lot of these other Russian maps have, which is like, there's kind of a sense that like things are always breaking apart and breaking down, and like things are in disarray, which I think is culturally a thing that is very relevant in Russia, and I guess Eastern Europe and, you know, the former Soviet Union. But his maps also have this like really playful side that makes them kind of stand out on their own. God damn it. So here's one thing right here. I fall down here and I can't go back up. Even though it's like chest high, which seems kind of goofy, right? Let's just kill these guys. But these teleporters just send you back up. So I don't have a... Oh, God damn it. Not that it really matters, because I'm going to pick up that Berserk pack anyway. You know, normally it'd be like... a lot of people might say, like, okay, why don't you just put stairs here? But adding teleporters that sort of come down that put you back over here kind of adds to the feeling of, like, uneasiness. Like, you can't traverse through the space normally. There's some sort of, like, unwritten rules or something that you have to follow in order for you to really... understand how to navigate the space, and they're not the sort of conventional rules of spatial navigation that you would think. And I think that is the kind of a thing that goes across all of his maps, and in particular this map. There's also a interesting approach to texturing and stuff, but it again, this is a thing that, like, I think rather sometimes unimaginatively people might complain about in the Doom community, but I think it usually makes sense, but it doesn't make sense in a purely like sort of logical way. It's more based on this kind of hard to express like atmospheric sort of thing. punch these guys. This map is also called Wood Prison, and there is a prison area of this map, but most of it isn't a prison. But it does have this kind of feeling of a prison, like you're trapped within these very large walls. Here's one example of these, like, staircases that go really high up. Also, there are a lot of dark spaces where you can't really see in front of you, which is true of a lot of maps in this set, but I still think it's interesting. Okay, there wasn't really much of anything up here, but I think one cool thing about there being so many... This is a huge map, as you can see. There being so many little, like, nooks and crannies and places where you can explore kind of adds to, even if they're not necessarily critical paths. One, I guess it adds to a feeling of, like, disorientation, but it also makes it more fun and unexpected what you necessarily will find in each part of the map. Okay. So here's another, like, really odd staircase here, where it just sends you up straight diagonally. Like, instead of choosing to enter from here, or, like, here's another entrance, and this is another entrance, as you enter through this, like, very diagonal doorway, which seems like it breaks some sort of law of, like, you know, physics or something. Like, it's just a very strange... Even though it's a perfectly easy thing to do in the Doom engine, it's just a very strange way to enter. And I think it kind of goes back to that, I guess, like, defamiliarizing thing. So this is an area that I actually have to go to later. Okay, I can't go in here. When I played through this last night, I missed a bunch of secrets, so I probably will again. Notice also how there are custom weapon sprites, which are pretty monochrome, like they're not like super dynamic, but adds to the more kind of dark theme, I feel like, of this map set. So I feel like they work pretty well. Who's shooting at me? You can see even with over 300 monsters, this map feels really empty. But there are enemies in places where it makes sense to have enemies. Like, if this map was designed so that, you know, I was constantly fighting enemies here, it would definitely take away from the overall atmosphere, which is kind of creating this feeling of desolation or isolation, where only individual monsters are sort of contained in these, like, little boxes or little areas. Like, I think there's a Hell Knight or a Baron down here. Yeah. So I can, also, one way to enter is to fall into this pit here. Really good lighting here, by the way. Having this kind of lighting in this area adds to the sort of disturbingness of it, because if it were just reasonably dark, that would be one thing, but the fact that there's this, like, very bright light coming from one candle here, you know, it's not realistic. It's not about necessarily reality. It's about creating some sort of mood, which is kind of what Doom has always been about for me. I think when people get too pedantic about texture alignment, or, like, you know, lights coming from light sources that seem reasonable, they miss out on some of this other stuff. I guess that is a good question to ask about. So this just leads me back up here. So it was like a little trap, kind of. Here's another one of these diagonal staircases here. Okay, there's a couple different ways up here. Okay, that just sends me back down. So this is another sort of, here we can just jump off and go back down if we decide to. I like that oftentimes he has the map, the option to just jump off of an area and fall back down if you want to. Yeah, there's like a little shelf here, I think. So here's a bunch of mystery switches. And these switches are not, I don't think, valuable to completing the level at all. They're kind of a side thing. Some of them look like they're on and off, but you can turn on most of these. I don't know what most of them actually do, and if they do much. One might kind of make this thing go down. I know one, like, turns on and off the lights. But this is a setup that is, like, echoed in one of his other maps, where these kind of mystery switches are here on the wall, and you just have to hit a bunch of them and see. It's not really something that, like, if we're thinking about puzzle design or something, it's not really something that seems to make a lot of sense. I suppose I could hit, like, you know, all of these. This, you know, darkens it and makes everything dark in here and brings this down. But I don't know what it actually does in terms of, from a, you know, straight up game design perspective. But that's okay, because it kind of creates a mood of maybe sort of impenetrability or something. And these monsters have this area, this is like kind of a hallway that just ends here. But this gives you a sense that there's something sort of a space sort of beyond this, just this castle hall, that there's this kind of other space. Here, I actually get a secret. Oh, okay, that's just the same. So these aren't required. You would think on a normal map that they might be required, but it's just all about kind of I don't know, that's the whole feature of this map, is there are a lot of side areas to explore, and they add to the overall feeling of the setting or the place, but they don't necessarily individually accomplish anything. Oh, I should probably... What? I have a BFG. Yeah, I could use a BFG on these guys. Okay. That works well enough. That's a weird sprite recolor of a BFG, but okay. I have plenty of bullets, so. Okay, this is a area. I think I might actually have to go to that area, but I want to finish up over here. Here, there's, again, like, you know, just like little forms or whatever that you can run up. There's no real reason to have this, but it just adds maybe to the overall feeling. It's kind of like a... It's kind of like this weird dark playground or something. Here's another pit that just connects up to the pit that was on the other side. I'm trying to remember where I even went now. Okay, I haven't been over here. You can get lost in this map pretty easily. But that's why there's auto map. It's not actually that hard. It's more about exploring it. A lot of the time, when there are doors in this map, you're not actually you can't actually enter the doors. I noticed this in a lot of Russian map sets. The environment, like, you try and open the door and it's just stuck. It's kind of like creating this sort of setting or place where things just don't work. Like, a lot of things aren't functional. And the normal way that you might have of traversing through them just doesn't work anymore. It's also another thing about this kind of setup is that oftentimes, you know, this, like, there's nothing important in this big doorway. You can't even go there, but something critical might be on this path that is this kind of obscure looking staircase. So it kind of trains you to travel in a different way. Note that I'm, like, not playing on easy or anything. This is ultra violence. It's just, I've heard that this map set was made much easier. Personally, I think it was a good decision maybe on their part, even though maybe Alt has more interesting combat, and I'd say overall manages to balance those things better. I mean, it's also just that there's more variety and creativity in the ideas, and the narrative comes together more, but I think it adds to the overall feeling that the monsters aren't necessarily the most important part of this map. The most important part is that kind of there being a sense of atmosphere or whatever that is that you can, you know, grasp. There's a lot of symbology. Like, I'm not... The upside-down crosses don't particularly speak to me, but one thing I always found interesting about the original Doom is that a lot of the hell levels were designed by Sandy Peterson, who's Mormon. And I think, actually, that makes a lot of sense to me because he has more of a sense of... no, you didn't ruin Sacrament by playing Alt first. They're not really related, by the way. Aside from having, like, similar mappers and styles. Not in terms of story, though. But, what was I gonna say? Goodness, I forgot. Oh, I hate it when that happens. Sure, I'll, like, see this in video later and be like, oh my god. I guess I was talking about the, if anybody remembers what I was talking about, please say so in the chat so I actually, in terms of quality and impressiveness, no, I'd say the moods are different. The Mormon guy, oh yeah, Sandy Peterson, it's interesting to have a Mormon design hell levels, somebody, you know, who might actually be invested, because it's somebody who might actually be invested in the idea of hell existing. And therefore might have a better sense of what that actually like, might have more of an emotional kind of relationship with the idea of hell, rather than, you know, somebody who is pure atheist or whatever. So even though me, as an atheist, like, I don't really think much about it, I can see that it has some sort of... There's some sort of relationship to that. Here, especially, there's, like, some weird implication. And this is one thing that I really wanted to talk about. There's, like, almost an implication between this being a prison and it also feeling very much like a church, like... That it's drawing the sort of parallels between a prison and a church, you know? I think there is, like, absolutely political stuff going on in this, and that's one thing that I feel like is... People would not even necessarily reflect on or think about. There's a little ammo stash here, which I actually need right now, so I appreciate. Here I'm gonna pick up a blue key. I like this area kind of wanders away from the rest of the map, and it's kind of like this little side area or something. It's like kind of going off on its own. It's taking you away from the main sort of setup or narrative, and it looks like some sort of harbor or dock, but then it ends in this altar right here. And, you know, logically, why would this make necessarily conventional sense? I don't know, but the fact that whoever, you know, the designer is, he was thinking about combining these two things together says, you know, something about maybe how he views these things as being related. So this will teleport me back here, all the way back here at the center. One other feature that I noticed a lot in Azumail's maps in particular, but some of the Russian maps in general, is that there are kind of unexpected teleports. Like, you'll make huge jumps in the continuity of the spaces just by stepping in one teleporter. So it's kind of hard to predict how these spaces will intersect. Here's another thing, too. It does not feel like you should be able to go through here, but you can. I'm not really sure about that decision, honestly. Maybe I would make them a little wider apart, but it does kind of add to this feeling of inscrutability or something. Like, it doesn't want you to go here, partly because this is what is allowing you to go outside of the space and into something else. One other thing I really like about here, you see there's a bunch of teleporters, and, you know, almost all of these will just send you back here. So it's nice to have a bunch placed so you don't have to go all the way around outside of the map. But you see, like, there's one here, and there's one all the way over there. And you might think, why the hell would one be all the way over there? You see, this one is misaligned, and it actually, you know, puts you behind the bars here into a secret. So I think that's very clever, because that kind of plays off the fact that there are so many teleporters, so one must kind of be different from the other, and that is in fact true. Yeah, I mean, if you actually try and get through these bars, like, you know, you will be able to. It's not like you have to, like, try really hard. It's just a matter of, like, you have to think to try and do it. And it's definitely, when I first played through this map, I did not think about it. I tried, like, it's like surpassing the limits that you put on yourself. Interesting. Yeah, I can see that. I don't want to go there right now, because I'm going to go to the area with an assload of monsters. It wasn't there. It was... can be pretty easy to get lost in this map. I think it... No, it wasn't there either. Okay, I think it was on the other side here. There's that other pit. Yeah, here it is. This area is really interesting to me because there's a bit more combat and stuff going on in it. This is like the center sort of altar area of the church. Oh, I'm glad that they're fighting. Jesus, what? Holy crap, I was not paying attention. Okay, let's save. Goddamn fucking revenant fireballs. All right. Because I might actually die if I'm not paying attention here. Oh, rocket launcher. So you're noticing that these zombie men have come out. Let me actually kill these guys. Pick up some health here. So this is like the central sort of church area. There are these portals over here that the zombie men just keep walking out of. It's like there's zombie people coming out of the portals that exist in the church. This is it's funny because I didn't really think about this like implication of Christianity being evil. But there seems to be a lot of that going on. I guess just the fact that this is being made as a Doom mod, it makes sense. Here, this is an area that's like walled off. It's like, is this a portal that was there? Is this a place that you should enter? No, it isn't actually. But the other funny thing that I find about these portals, you think there might be like either, you would think that either you can't come through them at all, or that they would lead you to some secret. But actually, you try and go through them, and it hurts you, and you can just keep going through them for quite some time, I think. And it'll just keep hurting you. It's a very strange sort of relationship you have with that space, and I like that a lot. I'm pretty sure I need to hit this switch to progress. So this is one area that I definitely have to go to in the level. And the area that was also sort of barred off that I ostensibly might not have supposed to have been... I shouldn't have necessarily gone there. That area was the other area I was supposed to go. So this will open up this here. I'll go back to the area with the Berserk just because I have 100 health. Or not Berserk. Soul Sphere, now that I have 100 health, just so that I can get that. I have no idea why this is a secret. Perhaps this opened up earlier when I hit all those switches. I'm going to guess that that's probably what happened. I would have to look at the map to actually see what it's doing. But an interesting thing also that you can't see on the auto map here, but on the Doom Builder version of this map, if you open it up, is that those portals are labeled with numbers. And I wonder if there's like some sort of, at least at one point, there was some sort of significance to them. So here's where we have to go. Might as well use a rocket launcher here. Oh, walk right into his fucking fireballs, okay. Jesus Christ. I'm glad this map isn't... So, here's another interesting thing. This is, like, actually kind of a big area, but it's, like, really off to the side here. And this is the also explicitly only prison area, but it's kind of hidden. And it's actually kind of hard to navigate in. And it's also, going here is the only way that you get a radiation suit to not get damaged and going in the next area. That's the only radiation suit in the level. So you can see that like this author, Azamail, is thinking about... the ways that you're able to access particular items are defined by the thematic nature of where you're accessing them from. I might die here because it's actually pretty hard to figure out where I'm going. The only way that it lights up is me shooting. There's no light amp here, from what I remember. It's actually worse with the sound on than it is off, because the sound off, I just stupidly wander through here without thinking about it. Again, more doors that I can't actually open. I don't think I... There are very few doors in this map that you can actually open. It's almost always... Progression is almost always through like some sort of passageway. So thankfully, auto map exists for a reason, and I will be utilizing that. You can see there's a switch through here. I don't actually know how to get through this area. I'm gonna resurrect Because this isn't a real playthrough. It seems like this is a really critical switch. It's not. It might lead me to a secret. You can't shoot it. I've tried many times. I'm not sure how to get there, but it could just be walled off, like a place that you're not... Because there are places in these maps where it seems like you should be able to access them. There's a switch and there's something there, but you can't. Which kind of breaks, like, the fundamental laws of, like, if you see something, you should be able to access it. That's one of, like, John Romero's design rules. But it's doing so in a way that has some sort of narrative or atmosphere or whatever implications. I don't know where I actually pick up the radiation suit. It's somewhere here. Oh, there it is. Don't know what that switch does. You might actually need to hit it, for all I know. But the one thing about the radiation suit is it actually lets you see here a little bit more, which is not its intention. But it also lets me go through this toxic area, which I otherwise, there's no other suits in the level for, as far as I know, at least around this particular area. And this is an interesting use of a crushing ceiling here. I was like, oh, there's no, like, comfort. Oh, it's crushing me. I like the looming open spaces, then having to move through very narrow passages to get from one place to the next. Yeah. There's a kind of a lot of extremes, like you go from very small passages to very big ones, and you go from very low places to very high places. This is where it can be easy to actually forget where you need to go, but I've actually been there. I want to make sure okay, so I've been through there. Yeah, so this is where, I'm pretty sure I've been up there. I think this is where I need to go. No. See, it's easy to forget. It's this very nondescript passage here. There isn't much on this side. There's a lot more on the, you know, on the opposite sides. But actually, this is where you need to go. I like, this is one of those areas where you can look over things, but you can't actually see anything when you go up to them. And this might just be practical reasons, like they don't want you to jump off after this part. But it also could be, you know, like you're not able to see them. I try and. Especially on Azamail's maps, like, it feels like almost everything is done very intentionally. So even if I don't exactly know what I'm trying to express, I feel like there's a reason for it almost all the time. But There are a lot of details like this where that you could say are unnecessary, and I wouldn't disagree with you, but they do add to the overall feeling of things sort of crumbling. See, I've fought 200 monsters, but it didn't even seem like it, because it hasn't been that hard. It's just been me wandering, really. So here's another area. Let's see if I can actually kill these guys. Super shotgun, not ideal from a distance, but whatever. Alright. Here's another area, another time where you're like, oh, another big door I should enter, but no, you have to go through this little passage. And these little things. Oh god. Okay. And here's one thing where I would say, from any, like, logical perspective, I'm gonna go down here just for the sake of doing it. It probably will just teleport me back up. But from any sort of logical perspective, you would say, why do there have to be that many doors? Why do you have to go through this area and keep opening these doors? One is, I guess it would, I don't really have any other way of saying this other than because you can. Like, it's something that you can interact with. And a lot of his maps, at every moment, there's sort of a thing that you can interact with. It engages you a little more. But at another level, I think it's kind of saying you have to unlock, sort of unpeel the layers here. And just having one passageway wouldn't have that effect, because here, like, the brick wall gets closed off. You can't go back through there. Which, actually, I don't know what that means for as far as teleporting me back here. Like, would I be stuck here? I don't know. I could try and see, actually. Maybe I'll save here. I'll save here and see where it teleports me now. Okay, I can still go back through that way. It just closes up. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, most of his maps. There are some maps, definitely by Russian mappers, that are pretty broken as far as that kind of stuff is concerned. But his maps tend to be a little bit more thoughtful about that. So here's a teleporter that appears. Sends me back to a different place, kind of strangely, right in the middle of this guts arrangement here. So it's like telling me something by where it's placing me when it puts me back on the teleporter. I'm not sure where the stained glass windows are from, possibly Heretic, but I also really like the details here. A lot of, like, impaled people and skulls and something on the wall of the castle, like, you're sort of trapped inside here. Now, strangely enough, I don't remember. Oh, I think there's some place that opens up. Once again, doors that do not open. Okay, I was there. That's where I was, also. Sorry, it's easy to get lost. All right. So I don't remember this staircase being here. If it was, there was nothing in it. Oh, never mind. That's how I entered. But this place, I think this was a wall here. I'm not entirely sure. And this is probably the most conventional Doom mod area. It's kind of like you're escaping the prison, the church prison. It's a lot more conventional combat. It can actually be a little bit difficult, but I like You know, so far it hasn't been too bad at all, and then it kind of amps it up a little bit. That toxic area too, it hurts you a lot, like it hurts you 20%. Which is the most, like, a toxic area can damage you. So it's definitely not somewhere you want to be in. Oh, why am I even doing this? Oh my god. Frickin' Z-Doom. I need to put this in, like, boom compatibility mode. Wait, didn't I pick up a Berserk pack? Jesus Christ. I'm sorry. That was embarrassing. See, I thought I picked up a Berserk pack, but it doesn't seem to be working out for me. This has a red key designation. Does not do anything for me. Again, another thing that people in the Doom modding community might look at and be like, why? And I can't quite say exactly, but perhaps there might be some sort of narrative implications for it. I wouldn't say, just from playing some of his other maps, that this is just red because that's red, like he's using it as a trim. I think there might be a more of a reason for it. Here's another Berserk pack. But I definitely want to make sure to walk among... Yeah, see, I got hurt 20% there. So, yeah, the environment is very toxic. You have an option to not get hurt, but you have to move very quickly. Like, I have to kind of duck in and duck out, and I have to take that risk that I might get hurt. That was really stupid. I'm sorry that I'm doing this. I'm just speeding it up, you know? Like, if I had to reload the saves a bunch of times, kind of take away from the sort of progression. But mind you, when I'm playing through normally, I don't just hit resurrect all the time. Nice little shadows here. Did I pick up that? I might as well pick that up now. This area is also themed differently, like it's less organic, it feels more like a Doom level, things are more boxy. It's like some kind of docks or waste area. It's where it's kind of, almost kind of like a no man's land type thing, like it has its own very strong sense of atmosphere. And there's those blue potions, but why would I try and get them? Because I don't think there might be a radiation suit, but like, I don't think that there is. So why would I go over there and risk getting hurt just to get a damn, like, get a few fucking blue potions? I don't know, it's a good question. Another medkit that I can't get to. Okay, so here's, like, this is the, going back to the doors not working thing, this is, like, the exit door texture, and no, you can't activate any of these. It's just there kind of as like a, maybe this is your way out or something. A lot of Azamail's maps feel like direct commentary on Doom tropes and expectations, and you always feel like you might expect that something is going to happen, but then it kind of flips it, and I just don't see that done very much. It seems like a lot of people, especially in the sort of Doom world and Doom mod community, if they stick to Doom, they do so because they like the tropes and they feel comfortable within that. And there's definitely a concerted effort here to make people feel uncomfortable with decisions that are being made. Again, oftentimes these are lift textures here. I think they might actually activate when I turn that on, but things have gotten more tech all of a sudden. Like, is this some kind of, like, regulator area? It's important to note the shift in mood, because it says something about the progression that this level maybe is trying to lead you through it on. Yeah, it activates those. They don't move like lifts, though. They just go straight down. Oftentimes a lot of playing with expectations. Like, sometimes you think a lift might come right away and it takes forever, and sometimes it just opens right up immediately. I don't know how to get up here. There's probably some way to do it. I'd imagine walking in one of these areas teleports you up. I think littering the area with those microboxes is silly. Yeah, perhaps. I mean, it's detail, but then you also have to balance whether it's really worthwhile to do that if someone's going to perceive it as something else. I don't really think it takes stuff away, but I might consider not doing that if I were making this map, but this author definitely has, you know, his own sensibility. Okay. Also, like, tiny toxic waste platforms here. Alright. So here's something that you actually wouldn't expect in this map. It gives you a cyber demon here. I'm just gonna run straight past him, because I don't care about... I have no respect for cyber demons. If I manage to not get killed, which might be, so I could totally not fight him if I, didn't want to, but the thing is, we thought that we went all the way through, we thought that we escaped the prison, and yet we're just on the other side of these bars here. We didn't actually escape. So that's Wood Prison by Azamail. I think kind of a masterpiece in terms of design. Really interesting. Lots of different things going on there. And it kind of defies categorization, I feel like. This is Seaport. God, I'm exhausted from talking about this map. This is also by Azamail. But it's much different feeling map. Okay, I'm going to need to turn the volume back up, because this is the only map in the set that uses a MIDI, which I find kind of funny. But this one has a much different atmosphere than the last one. I could probably turn it up one more. Of the mods you've streamed, this feels like a different game. It really is, not just in terms of, like, texturing or the new weapon sprites or using a different skybox and using the MP3 music. It's also that there's something far different about the design and, like, the intentions and the mood. So this is one area that might look a little silly, like, why is everything so meticulously detailed here? But I think it's kind of a more organic kind of little playground or sort of more fun feeling level than the last one. This is one reason I like Azamail's maps, is they often feel quite different from each other, even though there are things that, you know, are consistent. a lost soul in this area that's like a void. See, this is just an extra detail right here. I don't know. Perhaps I might be able to get there in a secret. Maybe not. But it's just there to kind of add a feeling of depth to the map. And putting a lost soul there kind of adds to this thing that this thing is wandering in a void. Also interesting bars here. This is a kind of a weird detailing thing too. I don't know if these are gonna open up or not. Okay, yeah. I thought so. The lost souls are opening up into a Red Falls area, which is kind of like, they're coming from that sort of setting. They're like lost or something. This track is Nemo by Nightwish. Yeah, it sounded familiar to me. Sounded like some kind of pop song anyway. I love these stairs because you can go up them like this. This is kind of an insane level. I've seen people do details like this, but not to the extent. Maybe it's almost like making fun of it. I don't know. I honestly like, I like how he sort of pushes things like ideas or tropes to the point of absurdity, and this is one example of that where you see people do over detail, but you don't necessarily notice it, but here it's like become surreal. Also these doors that don't go all the way up and do this like opening effect. I'm trying to think if there's any doors that I've actually, well, there's that one area in the last map where I opened doors, but for the most part opening doors isn't really a thing that happens. Here's like a portal that actually hurts you, which is a very Sandy Peterson kind of design thing. It's like you're not supposed to go there. I kind of wonder what's down in this pit, so we'll save. Oh wow. This is a death pit. No, no, it's not. Okay. I was gonna say, I would be upset at him for doing a death pit. I don't like death pits, even if they, like, fit into the narrative. I'm gonna load it, just... There's health in the crosses. A lot of details like that that are really nice, like if there's an area that attracts your eye or attention. Yeah, it's pretty close to a death pit. Yeah, it has the effect of a death pit without actually killing you, so I like that. There's another little echo of this. So this area is interesting. I usually just cross the bridge. Wait, I think I actually have to cross the bridge up here. Can I cross the bridge up there? No, I have to go down here. This is like a lot of concerted effort to make this feel as much like a cavern as possible. Like the geometry is very trying to match with this rocky texture. It's very jagged. We get to see the little view into the outside, which I posted an image of that. I'm not supposed to be able to walk on over the monsters like that, just ignore that. I don't know where, okay, a bunch of these imps are up there. There's probably a way to get up there. I don't know if there's a purpose for it though. I'm playing a lot, you know, worse than I would normally just because I'm trying to comment on so much at the same time. Uh, So here you go up the little passage here, and you could actually try and go down and walk among these like little cliffs, although I don't really think they get you much of anywhere. I remember I got stuck on them, but you can see the enemies are walking on them, which I think is kind of cool. You can see into the other side of the cavern there. So many rockets. Let's kill myself. Not waste my okay, I could use my chain gun too. Less to talk about in like this room, it's just kind of pushing you into a new area here. Interesting little details. This map feels more like some of the alt maps in that there's maybe a little less complete richness or complexity in the environment of the last map, but there are a lot of details, but it's more kind of big picture, broad strokes with the experience, which I'm fine with. So that's where I entered. Here's another upside down cross. Agua. You can see down here again. Another nice cavern area. I mean, this really does feel like a cavern. Here's that, like, it's obviously a lot of religious iconography. This texture might be from like Heretic or something. I don't know exactly. There's a proud tradition of stealing textures in these WADs, particularly from other like DOS games. So here we get to go back over here and you get a better view of this area that's really cool. I posted a image of it. You'll see it. I'll actually go down there so you'll see more of it. This is a 3D bridge effect that is used in a lot of Doom maps. I feel like it's used pretty well here because I could theoretically go down there, but it's used to create an effect going through this ravine that you wouldn't quite get the same if you weren't walking across this sort of bridge type area. A lot of really, really high staircases, which actually makes fighting enemies difficult sometimes. Look at, like, this is crazy. I like it a lot though. Oop. Oh my god. Nice. I had so much momentum that I shot myself up the stairs. Again, maybe unnecessary details, but you can walk up them. They're kind of cool. It does feel like a religious space to have these stairs here, honestly. Okay, and this just sends me back to the beginning. So this goes back with the previous map of there being this theme of it sending you kind of back to previous spaces. This might be so that I can go back and get secrets, but it also kind of... there's unpredictable relationship between the spaces. But here, instead of just going back right to the beginning area when I end the level, I actually go somewhere much different. So that's kind of cool. And I could go down these staircases, or I could just decide to fall down here. So I'll just fall down. Why not? This is one of my favorite areas in Doom, arguably. I posted an image of it last night. Someone was like, this is Doom? It's just a really excellent use of Doom geometry to sort of create a mood here. Like, it's using the varying light levels of the sectors. There's a lot of different textures that are used in here. It kind of creates this weird, like, layering. Almost looks like a layer cake or something. Little lights here to give it more of a... And this is where I could have entered from. It's a way to get back up where I was before. These little broken castles, which is definitely a common thing in this map set. There's a map called there's a map in this map set that there's a lot of sort of broken churches, broken castles. I'm not sure what this portal area does, really. Oh, okay, it puts me in the ship. I don't know if I can get into the ship otherwise. And I'm pretty sure I have to hit that switch, so... I don't know what it made go down, though. A lot of these cavern areas remind me of exploring underground in Minecraft. Alt had a great level called Recall that did that really well. Yeah, that was a good level. That one went on... That one had the problem of being a little bloated, like trying to be ultra hard and have lots of monsters and go on for a really long time. But there were a lot of really cool ideas in that map. That map was by somebody who I've never seen another map from. Their name was Madzy. He could totally decide to, you know, unlock all the revenants. Like, these could all be revenants, but he doesn't. And that's kind of an interesting... I mean, I've heard that they made this map set easier, which maybe makes it less fun for normal Doom competitors, but I don't really think it takes that much away from the experience, at least on these kind of maps. So here's a infamous lift here that I love. I don't... Like, you might have to count how many seconds it actually takes. I could see, actually, because I think there's a timer there. Okay, so let's hit this. Okay. Now I have to make sure to kill these guys. Still going down. Look how fast it's moving, too. Still going down. Still going down. Okay, how long did that take? 1448. So that took like 15 seconds? Maybe 12 seconds. I think that map had enough variety to justify the length IMO. Yeah, and it goes in really well with the narrative of Alt, so I think it maybe is a little bit too trying to do too much at once, but it is a really cool map. I love this outside area because it's a completely different mood. First of all, it's like at full brightness and it's this kind of garish textures. It makes me think of like Windows 95 3D or something. It almost seems like he's playing up the unreality of it by making this almost like full brightness level. I love this exit area, though, just because it's such a huge contrast from the previous several maps. you like are escaping now. There's just something kind of, both kind of eerie and comforting about this. Like, it feels like oddly innocent, this area, like, or naive or something. And after seeing what you've just seen in a lot of the other areas, not just in the last two maps, but in a lot of the maps before it, there's something kind of weirdly comforting about it. It's a kind of, like, catharsis without you actually doing anything. Or without giving you, like, super a lot of bonus items or whatever. Also, I think the MIDI adds to that feeling of, like, naiveness. It's very kind of goofy and tinkly and, I don't know, you just get a really strong sense of feelings which are really hard to describe, but are really sort of powerful. At least I do. Oops. Okay, there are no secrets on this map, which is interesting. But yeah, this is the exit. So those are the two maps by Azamail. I'm going to keep going, and those are really the ones that I wanted to talk about the most. But I'll talk about a little bit of this next map probably in some of the last map. Although I did a Doom mixtape video on last map of Sacrament, so I might not play through the whole thing. Yeah, that was called Seaport. This is Industrial Processing by Dragon Hunter. If any of you can make sense of this, like, text translation, I really wish they had somebody who was, like, good at translating to English to translate these, but... Basically, I think you're like inhuman, you're like a mutant or sort of after the apocalypse, or the apocalypse is approaching its final stage and... You're trying to escape the world. It's trying to go off of the trope of Doom and the apocalypse, but it's doing it in a more kind of disturbing and psychological way. You're like a mutant or something, and maybe you secretly want there to be an apocalypse on Earth. I really like this opening area. Okay, so this is Industrial Processing by Dragon Hunter. And Dragon Hunter is a fairly active mapper in the Russian community. A lot of his maps are very big, a little bit more conventionally Western in some ways in terms of how they approach combat and stuff. A lot of people who played through Sacrament, sorry, not Sacrament, White Mare and White Mare 2, which are the, like, speed mapped Russian sets, that I don't really think there's a lot of really interesting ideas. I don't really think they necessarily together have the overall cohesive atmosphere of Alt or Sacrament, which is why I pick out those two specifically. Because there are mappers on Alt and Sacrament, like Archie, made some maps for both Alt and Sacrament that are kind of more less conventional, more along the lines of the Azamail maps, but now he mostly makes slaughter maps, and is a lot more active on Doomworld and stuff like that. So I think I don't know, maybe it's just because this kind of style is unpopular, I feel like it got marginalized. And there is a kind of a group of people who like it, but I don't know. So here's one thing I wanted to say. So you enter this area. I'm going to turn down the volume. Oop, no, I don't care about that. All right, there we go. So to enter through this area, normally, you know, there's this big impressive machinery type thing. It's like imposing on the landscape, and it really adds a lot to this opening. A very strong, and the sky has changed too. There's like a blood moon. But one thing that I wanted to say about this is you can't enter through normal means. Like, there's a staircase. The staircases end before they go here, so you just have to kind of run to the staircase to here. And it's not hard to do, but just the fact that the staircases are not actually connected to the entrance says something about the way this map sort of treats these spaces. You can't enter through normal means. There's something different about it. And it's one of those things when I see people argue about sort of functionality. They're like, why would you do this? This is kind of viewed as like a newbie design thing. Like, that's just weird. But actually, it's done in an intentional way, and it might not be easy to sort of grasp how it's done intentionally, but it adds to the overall feeling of, like, that the environment is strange and that there's something different about this, that you can't sort of go through the normal pathways. And the fact that you have to enter at a corner, like, it isn't... Instead of the stairs starting at a little corner and then you having an easy way to get through there, you have to jump from these sides and over to this side to get to this entrance, which is obviously very clearly the entrance to the map. Here there's also, like, this is one of those things that maybe it's just a element of it trying to be more realistic, but there are two buttons instead of one button used here, so I actually have to bring this down with one button and bring it up with another button. It feels much more mechanical, which this map does a really good job of sort of having that. Again, these buttons put it up and down, even though there really isn't any purpose for doing that necessarily. Like, you could just have a line def trigger and have it do that, but it kind of, again, is one of those sort of things that adds to the feeling of it being this sort of system that it's more industrial, it's more sort of controlled. The way this door opens is very kind of BioShock. And then the area is very dark. The anomaly is this spiked man. This map does a really good job with atmosphere, and I feel like a lot of Dragon Hunters maps do too. It's less, maybe less so with the unpredictability of the design. And I think the one thing I wanted to say about the Azamil maps is there are more things going on in a lot of these maps, especially when they're at their best. There's probably more going on in, like, that Wood Prison map, the first one that I showed you. In that map, in 30 seconds, maybe a minute, we'll say a minute, there's more going on in a minute of that map than there is in the entirety of most AAA games. And I don't even think this is, like, disputable, honestly. Like people could try and argue against me, but I really think that that's true. And I feel that in a lot of these sets, and I think this is partly why something like Doom modding is so important, because it's a community that is, like, well explored. There's tools that are relatively easy to use. They're not perfect. It allows a sort of normal person who might not have access to big time commercial development tools or really the kind of time and energy to make something commercial. There's this makeshift community, though, that will actually play their things, and that's really important for a lot of this stuff, is the community, because Russian Doom has its own community and it has its own sensibility, and that kind of, I think that's how things sort of snowballed on top of each other and were allowed to develop into something more interesting than if it's just one person exploring their sort of own, you know, island sort of approach. But here the only way I can go is by hitting these switches up here. I don't remember this map so well, so if I get too stuck or lost, I might just go to the next map. But I just want you to get an idea. Like, this is a really good job, really good opening, and a really good job of, like, kind of portraying an atmosphere. Just as good as, like, Bioshock or anything else like that, to be honest. And maybe with some less bullshit than something like Bioshock has. That might, like, and I feel like a lot of people who are Doom modders, they consider something that shit talks the scope and scale of, like, a AAA game to almost be heretical. But you gotta have a little bit more faith in yourself. And I think there's so much in these things that just are not echoed in AAA games, but we're so obsessed with fucking spectacle. And it really prevents the sorts of ideas that a lot of, like, the first Doom represents, really, to me, from being explored, because there's so much obsession with the scope and the scale of, like, a AAA game and the spectacle. Another important point to make is that a lot of these are Russian Doom modders. They don't speak English. If they make an indie game and they use a lot of you know, non-English words and stuff, the chances necessarily of permeating into that sphere are not necessarily that big. I mean, there are Russian indie games. There's developers like Ice Pick Lodge, which are really kind of renowned and well-known. Still have kind of a cult following, though. But there's more of a chance in this Doom community that you're more on an equal playing field, because the text isn't really an important part. Most of the story is told through design. And you can get inklings of sort of culture and political commentary and a lot of really strange stuff just through the way that something like a Doom map might be designed. Here, the door is pointless, and yet there is a door, so it's another thing that I find interesting. The doorway has disappeared, yet there's still a door here. Again, another thing a person in the Doom world or elsewhere community might look at and say, like, what is this? This is too idiosyncratic and weird. But you actually have to think about this for a little bit and understand how it has that effect of, like, defamiliarizing, decontextualizing, which I think is so important to Doom, because when Doom first came out, it was such a alien sort of thing. There wasn't a game like that before. I mean, Wolfenstein existed, but a lot of the stuff in Doom is very strange, and it's very much not echoed in first-person shooters that were made after, really, the mid-90s, mid to late 90s. Towards the end of the 90s, you start to see some of that, especially the beginning of 2000s, you start to see some of that sensibility just completely disappear. So I don't remember this map, so relying on low light here. This one is actually a little bit more challenging combat-wise. Still very interesting in terms of its setup. A little bit more conventional, symmetrical, but it doesn't really matter because there's so much done with the lighting and the mood here. This, like, garden area outside. Again, it's there's a lot of effort being put into having these sort of outside views or this kind of, like, areas that you can't access, and that sort of echoing the mood overall of what it's trying to capture. Like, there's this thing that you want but you can't have because maybe your character has been becoming more and more dehumanized. I suppose that started with Half-Life and Halo. Half-Life does have a lot of the tropes of earlier FPS games. It's part of why I like it, honestly. I'd say Halo and Half-Life 2 are more kind of the setup of where things became different. But it honestly has to do with scope and engine limitations. I mean, if you look at Deus Ex 1 versus Deus Ex 2 is a really good example. Deus Ex 1 is a older, late 90s style engine. It's the Unreal Engine. Environments are bigger, but boxy. They're kind of mazy sometimes. A little more complex. And then you look at Deus Ex 2 and they built their own engine. It's more streamlined, but it's smaller. Maybe less of a sense of getting lost in this space, but it's been streamlined. And I know a lot of people shit talk Deus Ex 2, but it's a really good example, I feel like, of those changes in the industry happening in a really short period of time in the early 2000s. I think it's also the economy not being good, the society, culture becoming more conservative after 9/11, a lot of big companies like Ion Storm and stuff folding. The scope was getting, the technology was progressing, the scope was getting too big for independents to kind of come in. There's more of an emphasis on combining console and PC games together. That all happened in the early 2000s, and that's kind of where we're at right now, unfortunately, where I feel like we've really lost a lot of stuff. I'll actually reload here. Okay, where's that arch file? Nice. Not even explicit story, just explicit things happening. I'm thinking of Half-Life 2 in particular. Yeah, I can see that. Half-Life 2, I really don't like some things about it. It doesn't make any sense. Half-Life 2 is... It's like Half-Life 2 is an empowerment fantasy that's trying to take the moral high ground. Like, it's trying to be a nerdier story. It's trying to have all these weird engine features and puzzly things, and yet it is the most transparent empowerment fantasy kind of setup. That's what I don't like about Half-Life 2, honestly. The story doesn't make sense. Like, you're just a superhuman. Everyone says how great you are. There's no sense of, you're just this everyman anymore, like there is in Half-Life 1. Well, not that you were ever, an everyman, but you're this sort of hapless person who becomes, becomes something through that horrible, inhumane experience. And you never quite know what's going to happen in Half-Life 1. I'll just resurrect. I might not play through all this map, because I want to get to map 13. It might actually be a good time now. I don't want to, this map has a lot of interesting things, and I'm sure I'll be missing something, but I'm also getting a little tired. Who knows? I might come back to this. But you at least get to see what's interesting about this map. These staircases. There's so much of a strong commitment to mood above all else. That really takes the precedent over combat, and then combat is a part of that. So I'm just gonna go back to the very beginning of the set, because the beginning of the set does a really interesting job of capturing a sort of feeling. So here you're in your bedroom, right? There's this horrible low-resolution bookshelf. You can expect kind of a weird inconsistencies and low-resolution things in Russian Doom mods, but I find it kind of weirdly charming. But there's something is peeking through, like some kind of nightmare. The sink is overflowed with blood. There's a fried corpse here. You can't get into that cabinet. There's this eye thing in the middle of the hallway, blocking off pillars, blocking off. There's blood peeking out from these areas. This is very obviously trying to do storytelling. You can't open any of these doors. Now you're in this, like, starting to get in this blood cavern. There are enemies all of a sudden. You have to walk through this, down this very narrow passageway where you're getting shot at. Half-Life 2's entire mood was really weird. You were practically worshipped like a demigod, and yet you spent the whole game not really doing anything, just being shuttled around by people you just met. Exactly. It's just a really long tech demo. Now I'm in this, like, natural area. I feel like I've escaped my apartment, and yet I'm in this odd forest. Computer's getting a little choppy because of all the tree sprites. But I have to go through here. It's not entirely obvious that this is the dropping point. And hell is taking over. Things are frantic because you don't have much ammo. You're just trying to avoid things. There's this bloody train tracks here. You follow them. Things are starting to get more strange. Now you're lost in the trees. Oh, guys are shooting at you. Like some kind of firing squad. You can see the city that you're living in, like you're in the background, like you're in some sort of park or something. And then here you have another setup again where these guys are shooting at you from the side, but it's become transparently like this weird sort of hell cavern now. And I don't have any, like, I don't have a shotgun or any other weapons than the pistol, so I have to kind of just keep running. I would say this map might be kind of hard to 100%, but there's no secrets and not very many enemies, so if I really wanted to shoot them, I could. The level just ends before I pick up the key, you see that? Sorry, the stream didn't handle the tree lag well. Okay. Well, there'll be... this will be on YouTube, so... but you see, it ends when I try and pick up the key. Like, that seems like that would be the beginning of the level, but it just decides to end, like, right there at that kind of almost seemingly arbitrary point, and now I'm back in the same bedroom. But things are more normal. Like, this is just a normal kitchen. Normal bathroom. No guts. And go down here. I can't open these. There's gonna be some lag on this map. And this map, there are only 53 monsters. I don't even know where they are. I only fight a few monsters in this map. But this is just... This is actually kind of a walking simulator type map. Not... I wouldn't say... Because you actually do have to collect things. But you just wander, and it's really interesting. This author, Lanos, has done a lot of maps like this. Some of them are more combat-heavy, but they're very large, they're very city-based, and they're trying to sort of tell a sort of narrative, and you kind of go through them very gradually, kind of at a slower pace. And you see here the auto map. Like, when you look at it first, it's like, okay, no auto map, that sucks. But this these arrows are actually guiding you the path to the area that you need to go. So it actually gives you just enough information, I think, to complete the level. I like the music in this. It reminds me a lot of, like, Deus Ex and also, what's his name? Oh, God. Late 70s electronic musician, French. I can't remember his name. Did Oxygen and Equinox. Jean-Michel something. Anyway. All you do in this map, basically, is wander around. So one other thing here is, so I'm going to go up. I didn't do this until the very end. You see, you can do this in any order, which I kind of like. No. So it doesn't, exactly apparent that you can climb up there. You have to be a little clever to figure that out. But getting all the yellow keys isn't really required. So here's one thing that took me a while to figure out. You can get on the roofs here, and there's this open coffin over there. So if you get onto here, you can go inside there and pick up that yellow key. So you actually have to collect 6 yellow keys, which are not required to beat the level, and then a blue and a red key, which are... there's less to say about the kind of overall geometry. It's a lot more realistic in what it's trying to capture. But it still has that kind of sense of atmosphere to it. I think its relationships with Doom is like maybe more tenuous than the one in like the two Azamail maps of the Dragon Hunter map that I played, because this could be something else. Like, this could be another game, and I wouldn't really lose that much. But it is really interesting that people are doing this with Doom. I'm sorry if there are a bunch of... I haven't looked and see if... Let's see if there's a bunch of drop frames and stuff. Okay, there's a bunch. I'm sorry. I don't know why it's doing that. It was not doing that. Oh, this is irritating. I think whenever there's slowdown, maybe it does that. I'm sorry about that. It did not do that on any of my first 3 streams, and then, like, the last one I did, there was a lot of drop frames. I wonder if it's when there's slowdown in the game, it's more likely to cause that. Okay, I'm just gonna jump in here, because I don't fucking care. You get the idea anyway. This area is walled off. I don't actually think you can get to it. It's another one of those slight narrative things of, like, there are places that you can't go to. Here you do actually sort of have to follow the auto map to orient yourself. This is another good reference point here, because there's no building that looks like that. I wonder if... Yeah, there's nothing in there. I'm cheating by jumping. Sue me. Okay. Yeah, I'm wandering astray now. I'm going further from... Yeah, this is lagging on my computer, so you can imagine that it's probably lagging on the stream, too. This is really supposed to be played in PR Boom. It's just easier to play it for me in Z-Doom. But this is the critical path here. This park is the centerpiece of the map here. There's just so much detail in it, in this map, which is why... Like, all in one area at a time. Again, like, places that seem important you can't actually enter in. Once you sort of have that sense of that's how things are designed, that kind of makes you kind of understand what these maps are doing a little more, I feel like. Here's a convenience store or something. Actually, I have a Russian grocery store right near me, because it's kind of a Russian neighborhood, so it's kind of interesting to see. But it's all, like, these sprites of cans falling over. Like I said, this is choppy for me, so I'm sure it's choppy for other people, too. Now I literally have no ammo. But this is where I need to get the blue key, so... It's kind of like wandering around a level in Deus Ex, honestly. It definitely seems to be inspired by that. Both with the music and the overall feeling of the place. The sort of weird realism. There's something, like, one of the reasons why I like the first Deus Ex game is it feels dystopian, but in a, it's like a kind of, it's a realistic dystopian, like it's kind of bland, but the part of it being dystopian is that it is bland. So already I've gotten the two things that I need to get to beat the level, so I could just theoretically exit. I don't know if I've actually seen this area. Oh yeah, okay, this just goes outside again. There's another red key area back here, I think. Okay, yeah, this is the sort of bonus area where you can put the yellow keys. So you see, when I pick up a yellow key, it puts it there. It's kind of a cool feature, honestly. What happens when I get all of them is it removes all these bars that are here, and then I just step over that pillar, and it'll let me walk through this portal. And then it will send me back to another area, but there's, like, more ammo and enemies. I don't really know the point of that. There might be other things going on, but there's no secret level in Sacrament, so... It's an interesting idea nonetheless, even if there's not much reward for it. How do they even do that? I'm not quite sure. I don't think it's too hard to hack it. I mean, one thing I like... Yeah, you can teleport objects. One thing I like is just how, so much is done with so little in these sets. So I actually have to get up to this area through a different place from what I recall. I have to get on the roof or something to get that one key. There's a lot of keys that are just in corners somewhere. Like, if you wander around on this map, play it on PR Boom, I'd recommend. Or maybe GL... GZ Doom, maybe? Maybe it would run it faster, I'm not sure. But it'll run it faster than it's running it on my computer right now. Someone's shooting at me. And I don't have any ammo, so... But this is the main park area. You don't absolutely need to go here, but it's nice to wander around in the park, you know. It's honestly, like, kind of a letdown, this set, in a lot of ways, because after this map, which I'll probably just go ahead and beat this map so that I can move on, but you can explore more secrets. But after this map, it goes back to conventional Doom in a lot of ways, and a lot of the maps in the mid part of Sacrament are kind of more conventional. They're not bad, they still have that atmosphere, but it's a little disappointing, given what, like, is established on the first couple maps. And I think maybe that's what makes Lanos' maps work well by themselves, but it would be nice to see a set which balances the more and less combat, but where this feels more coherent. And I think alt is the closest thing to that, but alt is a little bit more heavy on the combat. What is this one called? This is called Doxylamine Moon. And this is still Sacrament. So exit area here. This map actually takes a while for you to be able to exit it. Can't go through these doors. Can't go through this door, but I can go through these doors. And there's this teleport. I think all of these teleporters go to put you at the same place. Okay, some of them don't work. Oh, I managed to just walk in the correct one last time, huh? That's funny. So this is like the symbol for the, like, this like Russian clan BOS that is what made Sacrament and alt. But it was kind of like a non-existent sort of thing. Like, I mean, it didn't seem to exist for very long, and a lot of these mappers have made other stuff, but I will say that, like, the ones that are credited to Clan BOS kind of have their own sensibility, even though there's some intersection. I like, so you this happens a lot in a lot of these maps. You activate this lift, but it's not a lift, it just makes this go down, and it doesn't, you can't actually go up. You actually have to climb this symbol thing. It is actually their symbol, and get through there. You can get through there. I'm just suck at movement right now. I love the music in this, though. I should find out what it is. This is an actual lift here. I'm not gonna fight those guys, because I don't have any ammo. That's the end of the map. Alright, so Wraith actually has a recent set that's a replacement for episode 1. It's called...